Morning! Welcome back to the Disney Wish! Kieran, good morning.
Good morning.
Wherever you are. I don't know where you are. Oh, there you are. The heavenly light below you, behind you, so you can't actually see who you are or what you are. There you go. We are heading to Nassau today, but this is going to be like our day on the ship because we're just going to, you know, enjoy the things that we've got booked and stuff. We have got the Rainforest Room booked today, which we'd like to try. You can only book that if you get it for the whole cruise. You can't just do a day pass on the Wish, if I'm correct, and it hasn't changed since last came on. This bed was everything. How was yours?
Very comfy.
Oh, look at the view. What a view indeed. Oh, look, we're here. Say that again.
I said it's back to bed. It's freezing out there.
We're in the Bahamas. I'm walking out there like, oh, yeah, lovely warm sun. Yeah. And he's like, oh, it's chilly. You need to move out of LA and come and experience what cold really is. So we haven't actually got like any major plans today. I think we're going to go and get breakfast in a minute and just explore the ship. So this is going to be quite a relaxing vlog, I think. So sit back, relax, and we'll just share the magic with you. I've asked Kieran to just lay in the bed.
Oh my god. Wow. I'm the other half live, man. Yeah, it's like being in a cloud. You just sink into it.
The pillows are something else as well.
This is really great.
Am I being banished to the sofa bed? Kieran's just in the shower and we are officially coming into the port. Look at that water. Stunning. We're heading to get some breakfast. We don't know if the concierge has like proper breakfast bits or if we're gonna go to the restaurant, but you're gonna find out with us. So we're gonna have a little moomish room. Come have a see what they got. A little bit of Pocahontas in the morning.
And to our guests on the open desk, cover your ears.
Yeah, our hold is awesome.
Okay.
Yeah, our horn's better than yours.
You wish you were over here.
We found a seat in the lovely Concierge Lounge. We were thinking about going to breakfast at the restaurant, but then we thought, if they do breakfast in here, it makes sense to actually use the concierge services.
We didn't spend a lot of time in here yesterday, so might as well make the most of it today.
Exactly, and this is the first Concierge Lounge to actually have a table service menu. So we have raspberry chocolate croissant, breakfast sandwich, avocado toast, steel cut Irish oatmeal, Mickey waffles, or French toast roll-ups.
Ooh. I think we're probably going to order one of everything.
Because it's included, we just, you know, we got one of everything. Apart from the oatmeal, but...
It was easier to tell them what we weren't getting on the menu.
And also, it's good to try it and like see what's good in here for you guys. That's what I'm trying to tell myself anyway. Let's go and check out what they've got on the selection. So they've got the coffee machines as per usual. Just need to wash my hands first. We've got a very lovely coffee machine, and then we've got some selection Good morning, how are you? Very well, thank you. Oh, the bed is outstanding. Oh, wow.
And this is avocado toast and a beautiful breakfast sandwich.
Oh, wow, awesome. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
We will.
This is a certified breakfast feast.
So, we've got the breakfast sandwich here, a raspberry croissant, the avocado toast, French roll-ups, and Mickey waffles.
Gotta turn this around for its full glory.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that.
That is gorgeous.
Good.
Gosh, based on your reaction.
That is really good.
I want to try.
I don't even know what's in it, but it's really good.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of flavor.
Yeah. And I love that it's just a little perfect bite-sized piece.
Mm-hmm.
All of this, like, we're not going to fill up on any one thing. Try it all.
I think if you wanted, like, one thing in particular, you need to order a couple of them to get, like, the proper portion.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, this is a pickup job, do you think?
I think this is a pickup job.
Okay.
Okay.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Mmm.
It's like having it on a cracker. Almost.
Yeah, and it's very, it's quite summery.
Mm.
Like, it feels like, it doesn't taste like avocado toast. I've never had a French roll up before. What is it? Is it essentially like a
pastry? French toast rolled up, or I guess it's bread with something inside it, and then...
Okay, so you
great
just...
description.
I don't know, it's okay. Give it a try. Oh, really good. That's like a sponge pudding.
Mm. It is more dessert-like.
Filled with jam. That's really good. It is raspberry croissant time. I'm not sure this is actually going to be doable without a plate, so I'll let you eat it first, and then I'll come back.
Let me go.
Ah, strategies.
Okay.
It's more savory than I was expecting.
Yeah, the,
Is that a cream cheese or something?
It's a cream cheese, yeah. It's a little tart.
It's nice, but it's not my favorite out of what we've had so far.
Mm. Will I eat it all? Yes.
I have chosen to opt out of Mickey Waffles because I can't put it in now. I'm full.
My mother taught me never to waste food. So here we go.
Damn you and your metabolism. As far as breakfast go, it's pretty spectacular. That felt like a brunch, you know,
yeah,
like we had a mimosa or something.
Yeah,
with
we
it.
Should have ordered a mimosa, I'm sure we can.
Yeah, well, they have like a whole, they actually have a mimosa cart. I'm going to go and show you. Look at this. So you can make your own Bloody Mary in the morning, you can make yourself a mimosa. These are the three options they've got. Prosecco there. Wow, all this looks like it's just for the wish.
Literally just opened the door and I was like, oh, okay. We've only been gone for like 40 minutes.
Yeah.
Right.
What did you say? You're like, oh, they do not mess around. Like,
they
just...
do not mess around.
Ta-da!
How did they do it this quickly?
I don't know. And it looks like it's like, how did they... Yeah! Like, everything's just put in nice places and...
Crazy. We were only gone for like, what, 40 minutes?
Yeah.
Crazy.
You crazy girl. So we've got a few more ships alongside us. We've got Brilliance of the Seas right here, which is a small Royal Caribbean ship.
Oh.
Oh.
Travel block.
No. For goodness sake. I never get this right. Ah. Independence of the Seas over there, which I think is one of the biggest ships in the world, I think.
Really?
I might. It was once upon a time. I'm not sure if it is now. I think it's Oasis of the Seas might be the biggest.
Gosh. The skill of the crew members, they reversed this ship in between these two giant cruise ships. It's insane.
Yeah, it is mad. Well, maybe don't go into the nautical business just yet, but...
Maybe not. Just reversing 100 million or 500 million ship.
And the rest.
Yeah.
Isn't the Disney ship that they bought from someone who was... It was already being built.
Uh-huh.
That's like 1.something billion that they bought it for.
I believe it, yeah.
And they're probably going to spend more on it to make it Disney. Senses Spa! So the Rainforest Room is open from 8 a.m. until sunset. The inside portion is open until 10 p.m. though. I think we just have to show our card and get a little band.
So we just collected our robes and we're walking down the hall and there was two ladies coming on this left-hand side. And then I was walking on the left-hand side and I was like, oh, sorry, I forget we're in America. And they loved it, they really loved it.
There's only so much I'm gonna be able to film in here because there are people in like bathing suits and stuff. So I'm just gonna pop our stuff down and hunker down for a minute. Lovely.
Sun or shade?
Shade. Complete shade or half and half?
Full shade.
Full shade. Oh, this is fun.
It like spins a little bit.
Oh, this is quite lovely, actually. Why? We've just seen there's a little fridge over there that has cool towels. So if we want to...
Towel toucher says.
Towel toucher says. Ooh. Nothing like a wet rag in the morning. Ooh, that's quite lovely.
Nice.
You can get your own.
I'm planning on sharing the same small town.
I would say worse things have happened at sea.
I think we can put it that way.
So this is $159 for the cruise. I think the price might have gone up since I last knew that price, but with the Wish, I don't think you can book day passes unless they have the availability to do it. And from what I hear, this books up quite quickly. So if you want to get access, my recommendation is to get it as soon as you get on board. But the space is lovely. And there's no one in here.
It's really, really nice. Yeah. Sure, there are the hot tubs on the ship. I really caught it on the boat. My god.
You're about to be cast asunder by all the cruise viewers.
This is such a nice space to have all to yourself.
Yeah, big time. And that is going to be a pro tip. If you want to come into the Rainforest Room, the best time is in the mornings when you're in port. Castaway Key especially, this will be empty. Empty indeed. But as the afternoon goes on, more people come back from the excursions and stuff. They come back for lunch, and that's when this will get pretty busy. Kieran said something very amusing, because I was about to get my book out and I was like, there's no point, we're gonna have to leave in like 5-10 minutes. What did you say?
I said, this is relaxation on a schedule, Adam.
We've got things to do. Because they've got the Walking the Wish tour at 11:30, where you get like a tour of the ship and they tell you all the hidden secrets and stuff, which we really want to do. We sat too long in the jacuzzi. Let's lie down on the nice bed. But now we have to go.
I wish we didn't have to move. We're coming back.
Though, I mean, we can just skip it.
We're so torn.
We should
so
do the tour.
We've had a little spruce up. Redid the hair.
Ready to go.
Going to deck 5 midship to check in at the Sword in the Stone Lounge or something? The coffee shop. Oh, the princesses are downstairs doing their meetings. Also got Goofy there and Pluto.
Different from the other ships, they actually give you an earpiece to listen to the tour here, which is great because previously it would be very crowded and everyone trying to listen to the same cast member and it didn't really work, so. Now I just got to figure out how to put it on.
I'm about to pour Coke all over myself.
Yeah, well, welcome everyone, and where are my DVC members? Welcome home, it's nice to have you all here. So some fun information about our ship itself. The Disney Wish stands at 1,156 feet long. That, for our friends in England, is 3 football field lengths.
So we've had a little introduction as to what the Wish can hold in terms of guests and crew. And now we're heading into Arendelle for a little talk about the space in here.
The Arendelle experience showcases a lot of different elements, but specifically telling the story of Anna and Kristoff's engagement, hosted by the party planner Oaken himself. Yes, Oaken has a side hustle.
Just had some fun facts about the chandelier and that it's inspired by the transformation scene in Cinderella.
Just finished the walking tour. It was very enjoyable. I would say that if you're looking for something to give you a brief overview of what the ship looks like and the layout and stuff, I would recommend it.
Yeah, I think if you're doing a longer cruise, definitely something to do early on in the cruise, on the first couple of days.
Yeah,
so gives you a good kind of layout of the land.
Get your bearings. I think, because they talk about the different medallions in the carpets and like how to find your way around and navigate. Enjoyable.
Hold 5 seconds. Ta-da. We've come to the concierge sun deck.
Yes.
Kieran's living his best life, lounging on the sofa.
Oh my gosh.
Like, to have a view, which when you look out to the sea, and we got some nibbles for lunch. So we've got a sushi dragon roll here. There is a Capri sandwich, and there's also a afternoon menu, which has a traditional Hungarian goulash. A gambas pilpil, what's that?
No idea.
Any idea? Stuffed grilled vegetables, grilled chicken panini, or an all-American slider. Oh!
Oh, yes.
Mariana said that the all-American slider is a must.
Yeah, she said it comes with two, so perfect.
And there's also a chicken pot pie!
Just what you get when it's 29 degrees.
Yeah!
These chopsticks are very fancy. They feel like a Japanese chef or something. These are the type for one. They're very heavy.
No wood here.
I've never had a dragon roll before. I've had a California roll and stuff.
Good.
It tastes like a tuna and cucumber sandwich.
Hmm. Is that a good thing?
Very British.
Okay, nice.
Yeah. What did you have?
The mango lassi.
Mango
like
lassi.
A mango flavored, like creamy, yogurty kind of drink.
You've just reminded that they have the Dole Whip smoothie. Over.
Oh yes, yes.
So I'm gonna be getting one of those in just a moment.
Oh my gosh, do you think? Let's get a Dole Whip smoothie and get them to add rum.
So it's like a spiky pineapple.
Yes. Oh yeah? My god, yeah.
That's Can so I try good. It? That's not mine.
Not for
not
you.
My no, I'll have the virgin. Food has arrived. So we've got two American sliders here. A chicken pot pie, which looks like almost like a cross between a chicken pot pie and a shepherd's pie. And there's also a chicken panini.
This all looks so good.
It's good that there's one, like two of everything. Yeah, yeah. Way, so we can share it.
That's really, really good.
Well, that's very homely.
Yeah.
Which apparently means something else in America.
It does, yeah. Homey and homely are the opposites of what you expect they should be.
Really?
If you say something is very homey, that's an insult in the US.
Homely.
Homely is the right way. Homely means good, homey is bad.
It's good. I'm going with good. When we got chatting to Mariana earlier, she said make sure you come and try the American sliders. Kieran's just tried his.
I broke the cardinal rule of vlogging. I ate it before. I couldn't help myself. It's so good. It's delicious. It's
yeah, really, really okay.
Mmm. Good.
You can tell the quality of like the meat and stuff. The chicken panini is particularly good as well. I think the standout of the cruise so far for me compared to like the previous cruises I've done, obviously this is concierge, the main difference is concierge, but it's been the food in the lounge, I would say. And just the lounge in general, just sitting.
I couldn't agree more.
Like,
yeah.
The view.
The fact that the food in the concierge lounge is a la carte. You order what you want, it comes out hot and fresh.
And so the quality's outstanding.
Amazing.
Along with outstanding service as well.
Yeah.
Like everyone's 10 out of 10.
Nothing is a problem.
Nothing is a problem. And we haven't had any problems. So, win-win. We are heading to the Hero Zone to try and do the Incredibles inflatable race thing.
Yeah,
obstacle course. We don't know if it's gonna be busy or not. Oh, wow. So I'm gonna guess the line is just here. So I think it's like a race.
Oh, okay, who's gonna win?
Not me.
When you go inside the Incredible course, you must be 40 inches or taller with only those socks on your feet.
A race right now or chasing?
We're gonna try.
Race.
I've only got one hand, so.
You ready to go in?
Yep.
Okay, in 3, 2, 1, race!
I'm losing! Oh god. Whee! Okay. Well done.
Hey, win it.
We won by a mile. Thank you. In conclusion, Kieran won. But it was very good fun.
It was a lot of fun. Yeah. If I was a kid, I would just be on that all day. It's open for an hour and a half. I'd be here for an hour and a half.
Well, there's lots of kids that were saying like, oh, we've been four times. I was like, four?
Very fun.
I got a massage after this.
Right.
I'm now heading to a 75-minute deep tissue massage, which is one of my favourite things to get when I'm on a Disney cruise. What are you going to do with your time, Kieran?
I'm going to go and ride the Aquamouse, and when I'm done with that, I'm just going to go and relax in the Rainforest Room.
You look like you've shrunk a lot. Oh wow, it's a miracle! To the salon!
With your fish holding tight, to the string of your kite.
All right.
Good luck.
Enjoy.
Have fun.
The
oh, I will. When checking in for your treatment, you have to fill in a form to talk about what may be bothering you. And they also give you a selection of additionals, but in my experience, these aren't necessarily worth it. And this is what happens when you have a head massage as part of your 75-minute. I see my hair in the viewfinder. Very nice massage. I was just telling Kieran, like, the type of massage you get is very much dependent on the person you get. So, like, even though they've all got the same kind of script, I've probably had four different versions of the same massage over the time that I've been going on Disney cruises and stuff. What did you get up to, Kieran?
I rode the Aquamouse, which was very, very fun.
Yeah.
It took me about 30 minutes in the line, and I rode it by myself, going up the conveyor belt, watched like all the Mickey Mouse cartoons. I think there's a story, but I didn't really follow it. Anyway, it turns into the slide, and then you get to the part where it, like, the water jets like propel you upwards, which is definitely something I haven't experienced before. That was really, really fun. And then I got to the end, and the conveyor belt had stopped, and they said, like, over the PA that there was some issue, and they would let us know when they were back up and running, so I only just made it on, thankfully.
Oh, wow, so it broke down afterwards?
Yeah, yeah, they had to literally come down and kind of pull me out of the raft because I didn't quite make it to the to the end part. And then I came to the Rainforest Room and I tried all the different showers, and there was one shower where I was like, I nearly drowned. There was so much water. I don't know how you drown in a shower, but I nearly did. And I tried the hot tubs and the steam rooms and the cold rooms and the hot rooms. It's been great. And now I'm just sat here watching a movie. Good.
But I think, like, the Rainforest Room, if you're looking for a relaxing cruise, is, yeah, well worth it.
Yeah.
Like, especially if you're just coming on an adults only cruise, like we are, it's very nice. It's, yeah. And it's, I'd say the only thing that's difficult is trying to get the most use out of it on a 3-night cruise.
And I think as well, with us also being concierge, like this area out here with the hot tubs and the nice seating and stuff, like you can also get that in concierge.
Yeah,
so
this outside bit is very similar.
Yeah, yeah.
But the sauna and steam room and stuff like that, that's obviously like the difference of the hot beds.
Yeah, 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 yeah. So if you're not in concierge, this is, I think, a great addition.
Yeah.
It's worthwhile.
It's kind of like, if you want to have an adults-only concierge or this, would be great.
Yeah. You don't necessarily need both,
no.
I don't think.
No,
yeah.
I agree.
Yeah.
We've popped back to the room to get ready for dinner. I just had my shower, and it looks like we're sailing away.
We're leaving.
We are sailing away. I'm sorry.
Do you have a little bit of hairspray I can use?
I do have a little bit of hairspray. I have a lot of hairspray that you can use.
Thank you.
If you need it.
My hair is already falling apart and I've just stepped outside.
Oh, it's right here. So we are nearly ready. We're going to head to the concierge lounge and get a pre-dinner drink. And then we're going to Palo this evening, which I haven't been to on the Wish, and supposedly it's called Palo Steakhouse. So they've rebranded it a little bit. Probably not going to have a steak because I had steak last night.
I had steak last night.
I'll probably have a steak.
And the good thing about being a platinum member is that you get a complimentary meal at Palo, or if you don't use the, because it's a preset menu, but if you don't want to use that, you can get $90 instead of that. Hmm. I think. Wow. We will go on. Ooh, little treats. Disney's cabanas. Ooh. Mm. Okay, we'll look at that later.
Put that in the room.
Thank you. Oh, wow. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Look at that. Here will be nice. Not too shabby for old Adam and Kieran.
Yes.
So used to saying old Adam and Gary C.
Rolls off the tongue,
yeah. Little pre-dinner treat. So we probably shouldn't do this for Paolo, but oh well.
It is what it is.
When in Rome. How's your espresso martini?
It's good.
Yeah.
With absolute vanilla. And so it has a little hint of vanilla.
Oh, did he recommend that and then you were like, yeah, go for it.
Yeah, yeah. He said it's the best espresso martini on the seven seas.
Can I try it, please?
Oh, be my guest.
Thank you.
Oh, well, that's just divine.
Pretty good, huh?
It's got alcohol in it.
Little kick.
Little.
They had some savory bites and they also had some sweet things as well. So this one is like, I think it's a spinach bread. One has got prosciutto in it and one's got ham and cheese. It's bad when you get into habits where you start dividing up your food and then just like sampling, you know, we're gonna have one of everything.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's good.
I think it's cheese and bacon, but ooh, very good.
Okay, I have to try that.
Been on the ship for over 24 hours now. What do you think of Disney Cruise Line? I just looked at the viewfinder and saw that pose.
Well,
I mean,
it's absolutely miserable. If you're thinking of doing it, don't bother.
Leave it for us. Yeah. We'll do the burden.
I think this really says it all. It's just, it's incredible. It's really incredible. Compared to the other cruise lines I've been on, just the entertainment and the shows and the quality of the food, quality of the service, it's all like the best of the best. It's worth the price. There's been one single, we've eaten countless number of things, and there's been one thing, which is an Oreo cheesecake bite, which I thought was okay, but literally everything else has been incredible. Incredible. So I think that goes to show that just this tiny little cheesecake bite, which I still ate, by the way.
If you had to pick one standout of the cruise so far, whether it's a moment or a thing.
Probably seeing Mickey and Minnie come out on the set.
Yeah.
Yeah, I loved it.
That was, I think that was probably my highlight as well.
Yeah.
Which isn't part of the concierge experience, so it just shows like...
True.
The whole ship in itself is... premium.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, actually, I thought of another thing.
Go on.
The hand washers.
Oh, in the kids' club, the yeah.
Kids club. Those things are incredible. They need to install those everywhere.
That'd be great if as you're going into dinner, instead of like doing the little hand wipe thing, everyone did that.
Yeah.
That'd be great. We've mentioned her a couple times in the vlogs, but Mariana is the best.
She's great.
Kieran was just saying,
I'm so impressed by like how much they can remember. Like it's not only just they remember your name. It's like she just asked if we have enough water and Diet Coke in our mini fridge. Like she remembered what our drink preferences were.
Yeah, and Diet Coke to you is very important.
Very important.
So
you hardly ever see me with
Kieran
that
is sold. But they're all great. But Mariana's the one that we've like spoken to the most, and. I just want to take her with me!
Step aside, Mr. Bimbo. I shall be taking you
out! Oh, that's a wall. Okay, so pay attention. Don't just vlog.
Thank you.
Oh, wow. Ooh,
lovely.
Awesome.
Wow.
Thank you.
Awesome.
First impressions. Wow.
Yeah.
Very good, like, server spiel.
Yeah.
We've got this gorgeous view out over the ocean.
Gorgeous.
Amazing.
$160 you said?
$167.
Wow. An IVV from Florence.
Yeah.
Wow.
Our lovely server Denise explained how the platinum reward works. So basically, every person who's in your cabin, as long as there is one platinum in that cabin, everyone in the cabin gets $45 to spend in Palo. So together we've got $90, which is quite nice.
Mm.
We've had a little walk through the menu, and I'm so torn. I don't know what to have.
Any idea?
I wouldn't call it a little walk through the menu. That was the most detailed description I've ever received of the menu. It was incredible. She really went through and told us like all her favorite items and like the most intense detail. It was,
and with like personal touches, yeah, and like
incredible.
The chef already that's on is really good at making this, yeah, and like, yeah, etc. Yeah. So
it's made it very, in some ways, easy to decide, but also very difficult to decide. At the
yeah,
same time.
She could not talk more about this agnolotti pasta. So I think I'm gonna have to go for that.
Mm, me too.
Oh,
she really talked about it.
We've gone a little bit off book because we were gonna do appetizers and then a main, but we've chosen to do pasta and a main.
Mm-hmm.
So I've gone for the gnocchi and then the sole, which is a fish. And Kieran,
gosh, put me on the spot. What did I order?
You went to the agnolotti.
Agnolotti and ossobuco, which is a veal, I think. Is that right?
Yes, yeah. But it's like famous for this restaurant.
Yes, yeah. It was on the Magic in 92 or something, is that right?
When they first.
Yeah.
1998, I think it was.
98, yeah. Okay, yeah.
But then I was like, oh, Kieran, are you going to get a cocktail? And he's like, no, the espresso martini was fine.
Yeah.
And then I order a French martini, and then he's like, I'll have a white Russian. And I was like, hang on.
I'll drink alone.
So we've been served an amuse bouche. It did come with a mushroom sauce, so I very quickly passed it over to Kieran's plate. But our server noticed, and she was like, I'll bring you one with a gorgonzola sauce, which was very nice of her.
Mm.
Yeah?
Mmm. Mm.
There you go, that's your review, everybody.
Good.
Get all the sauce. Not only have we been served bread and the famous agnolotti, but also the gnocchi has had fresh parmesan grated on it, and I'm just so excited.
Very excited.
Mm-hmm. That's really good.
Mmm. Mmm. This is the best thing I've eaten on the ship.
Out of five? Mmm.
Yeah, this is so good.
Can I try it, please?
Of course.
Thank you. Yeah.
Pretty good.
How do they do that?
It just like melts away in your mouth. Mm. And like the brown butter and...
It's like eating three things at once.
Totally.
Very, so I get half good of this, right?
Yeah.
As far as dinner view goes, as far as dinner's view, what is it? Plural. As far as dinner views. Okay. As far as dinner views go, this is a pretty good one. Oh.
The goose.
The goose.
I think I saw it go green.
Did you?
Yeah.
I've got it on camera, so we can see if we saw the green flash.
We were just talking about the green flash. We have to look back at the footage.
I feel like you've done this before.
Almost every day.
It's going to be like in those cartoons.
That's what I always say.
Oh,
like
gosh.
Tom and Jerry.
Yeah.
Like yeah. Or 3D bird, I don't know.
This is the sole. This is the osobuco.
Mmm.
Look at that.
Wow.
I'm very excited. Can I watch you cut into it? Because you said it like.
Oh,
apart.
Yes. Let's see. I can't figure out which way around these knives go. Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Look at that. You barely even need a knife. You could eat this with a fork.
Just falls apart.
Yeah.
Mm. It's really, really good.
I'm very excited to try this. Good.
It's so buttery and delicious. You're gonna have to try it.
I will, definitely.
Good.
It's extremely hot. See this steam? Including the ramekin is very, very hot. Have your chocolate sauce and vanilla sauce.
Wow. They offer two souffles for dessert. They've got a amaretti, which is like di Serrano, and they've also got a chocolate one as well. Treat yourself.
Give it a little try. I guess we go in through the middle, huh?
Uh-huh. Dig in. Mmm. I think if you don't like almonds, you might not like it, but it might be worth trying.
Yeah, I'll give it a try.
I think it kind of goes without saying, but this is a 5-star plus meal, and Denise, our server, she said at the start of the meal, she was like, this is the best Paolo. And I would agree with that statement. So if you are coming on the Wish, and if you're on a 4-night cruise in particular, or you're on a 3-night cruise and you don't mind skipping one of the meals, I'd recommend it. I really would.
Would you recommend it?
This might have been one of the best meals I've ever had.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I would agree with that.
It was outstanding. Yeah.
This is scroppino. It's raspberry sorbet, apple brandy, prosecco, and limoncello.
Lovely, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. The palate cleanser.
I've just tried it. It's a bit alcoholic for me.
I don't know if there's alcohol in it, is there?
Brandy, yeah.
Oh.
Pretty sure that's an alcohol.
Tastes delicious. Consider my palate cleansed.
And limoncello as well. Oh, I think that's an alcohol as well. Would you like a second?
No.
It definitely pays to take a lot of Disney cruises and become platinum, because that meal only cost us $46.29.
Amazing.
And a little heads up. So the 18% gratuity that's put on the bill, that goes to the whole team. But if you want to leave more for your server, which we're definitely doing,
absolutely,
she was outstanding, you have to put that there.
So good. So, so good.
Very good. It's got to be the highlight of the cruise for sure.
Yes. We've got 20 minutes until The Little Mermaid starts. Still in two minds about whether I want to go or not because of what happened last time, but I think I should give it a second chance.
Give it another chance.
It's been a long time since the first showing, so we'll see if they've improved it. We're just walking past the Pirates of the Caribbean show.
Okay, let's all do it, everybody!
Okay, so I'm gonna sit on the aisle seat. Okay, so if I want to abandon, I can.
Hit me.
My review, The Little Mermaid.
I think it was good. Overall, I enjoyed it. I think the
production of it was impressive. Everybody was incredible singers, but there's definitely something that's just a little off about it, I suppose. Like, I think maybe it comes down to the pacing of it. Like, the big numbers are great, but there's a lot of kind of like smaller filler parts which get a bit slow.
I've come to a conclusion of what I think it is.
Yeah.
It's like a dramatic interpretation of the story of The Little Mermaid.
Yeah.
In that the costumes don't change. The costumes are like basic drama clothes.
Sure.
And like you have people who make a cauldron rather than just a cauldron.
Right.
And I think a lot of the time, the thing that bothers me about it, right, is these are meant to be like Broadway standard shows, and the talent on there is Broadway standard, hands down. But a lot of the time you're looking at a black floor with black sides and three set pieces which have no relevance to the scene. And that's the thing that I was just like, this is not what I like about Disney shows.
Yeah, and it's also hard to follow up yesterday's show as
that
well,
was so
which
good.
Is
so it's not for me. And not everything's gonna be for everyone. That's just how it is. But I'm glad you liked it.
Yeah, it's good. I'm looking forward to landing tomorrow.
Walking up like 7 flights of stairs after seeing the show. Ain't the best.
Eating all day.
Such good food though.
I was gonna say, I'm gonna have an ibuprofen. The perils of turning 30.
Oh my god!
What is it?
It's George of the Jungle. George of the Jungle. it's King Kong.
Is it?
What's a Disney gorilla?
The Jungle Book.
Oh.
I wanna be like you. Ooh, ooh. Mm-hmm. That guy.
Mm-hmm.
King Louis.
King Louis. And a coin.
Outstanding.
Oh, because it's Pirate Night.
Uh huh. Kieran is already making himself comfortable, but we do have fireworks.
It's dangerous.
Tonight.
Yeah, we have to leave again.
So we have got a cabana in Castaway Key, which we're very excited about. Booking a cabana is a very difficult task. If this can help, I've booked 12 cruises. This is the first time I've been able to do it. And I'm a platinum, and we're setting concierge. So you have to have a lot of things in line to be able to get a cabana. So take that with a pinch of salt, what I'm about to tell you. So we have been given this little envelope, which has some details related to our cabana. So I'm just going to read this now and then give you the 411. So we have one for me and one for Kieran. Lovely. And what is this? Oh, this is the price. This is the thing I didn't want to see. <'Cause> I know it's
the bill.
It's very. By the way, this is how much you're paying for this. So we have got a Serenity Bay cabana, which is the cheapest cabana you can get. That is $399, and that can be up to 4 guests. A family beach cabana, which is along the family beach, obviously, that's $599, but that can host up to 6 guests. A grand family beach cabana, and I think there's only one or two of those, is $949 and can hold 10 guests. So even though it's the cheapest option, $399 for a day is a lot of money. I'm not under any illusions there, but I would always like to try one. And so here we are, and we'll let you know more about that in the next vlog. It's firework time! Ooh, it's very bright out here, isn't it? Compared to my lovely serene
very
room that we just...
like, you know when you're good friends, when you can just literally just zone out on your phones for 10 minutes, like, I needed that.
We have come to the funnel on the right-hand side, which is the starboard side, if you're into nautical things. But this is the side that they send the fireworks off to. They are doing the rocking show that me and Gary saw last time.
It sounds great, whatever's happening in there, but...
No, we ain't gonna take it.
On a cruise shore, you really just gotta pick and choose what you wanna do.
Well, that's what we've literally come to the conclusion of, is that there is so much to do. 3 nights isn't long enough if you're brand new to Disney cruising. Yeah. So if you want to get the full taste, I would say 4 or 5 nights minimum as your first cruise. Ooh, I missed...
Ta-da! You missed a little flare there because I was too busy about to do a clip.
Oh, I missed it again.
Sorry. The smoke of the fire effects. Woo! Oh, I got one. Yay!
That was amazing.
We are not sinking. This is not the Titanic.
Well, I'm tired. Me too.
Very ready for bed. Oh, dear. Well, fireworks, good, yes?
Yeah, I loved them. Yeah, it was cool.
Highlight of the day?
Power.
Agreed.
Incredible.
Agreed.
Yeah.
Tomorrow we are going to Castaway Key. We have a cabana, which I've never done before. I am so excited. I could cry. But I'm going to get into bed, as is Kieran.
Yes.
So, like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to see other future stuff. Check out Kieran's stuff in the description as well. He makes models from around LA, and he's also on Instagram as well.
Check him out.
Subscribe to your channel. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.